is the basis. Well, lots of changes have been brought in CPF, which can be really troublesome to us. I'm not talking about criminality per se. But our doctor can be sued in all the three places. Criminal case, medical counsel case, and consumer fora case, for single case. All the three cases can be filed. Now, let me give little insight about criminal case before I go to defenses. Criminal liability with the changing era has been changed quite a bit in medical practice. Earlier, even the authorities were knowing only one section, and in past we have seen multiple cases which was filed in a criminal liability against the doctor is only one section, which was 304A. Now what is this 304A of IPC? It says causing a death without intention with negligent act. Like I am driving a car, my intention is not there, but suddenly I dash someone, he died. Like in Salman Khan's case, six people died. But he got bail immediately because section is very small. So same section applies, even if death had happened, you will not be troubled by the police. Because being a bailable offense, all of the benefits are there, so you will be taken care of. We enjoyed a lot. Because slowly we come to know about that, so fear was not there. But now I have seen lots of changes in interpretation by the young lawyer. Because the crowd which is now coming in a medical practice, or sorry, in law practice, are an intelligent crowd. Because they give entrance exam to do LLB. When they are doing entrance exam, means they are passionate in law. When they are passionate in law, naturally they are going to do a lot homework. So now the advocate, which new advocates are coming in our country, are very intelligent advocates. So they interpret the words. Now interpretation has changed scenario altogether in our medical practice. Now I will give you one or two cases to make you understand. 304 has been converted to 304 part 2. Now what is 304 part 2? It says causing a death with the knowledge that particular thing can cause a death. The word is with the knowledge. And the moment this section comes, it becomes non-bailable offense, 10 years punishment. In the past, I have seen many of the people who got arrested for this. Even one gynecologist case, she was behind the bar for almost 62 days, 2 months. I have got multiple cases where people remain for 2 months, 3 months, because being a non-bailable, it is a discretionary power of the judge to give a bail or not to give a bail. Culpable homicide. Let me narrate you one very latest case of Ratnagiri, Mumbai, where post-delivery, patient got discharged. But we know that post-delivery fever is common. The lady got fever. This couple were out of station. She approached the hospital. Nurses has called the doctor. She came with a history of fever, body ache and all. Thinking that probably it is a post-delivery fever, it is very commonly seen, they advise the medicine on telephone. Give paracetamol, give antibiotic. It is a routine habit of today, yours also. You know, many of them, we do give a phone consultation. But patient died because of some other element. But act was giving a medicine on a phone. Police has filed an FIR against this doctor under 304 part 2. When this doctor has gone for anticipatory bail, even up to High Court, you know, down court has rejected. It is an observation by High Court without clinically examining the patient, palpitation, oscillation, temperature, we do 80% is a clinical. No? Without clinically examining the patient, giving a treatment itself says that team of doctor were having a knowledge that if without doing this I prescribe a medicine and death has happened, which has happened in this, then it is purely attracting three or four and we got rejected. Are you getting me what I'm sharing? So I have got multiple cases where 304 has been now rampantly be used in our country because people are now interpreting the things in their way. Very latest year Gujarat case which I have got, where this lady has gone to with a progressive liver pain to this hospital. Doctor was out of station. On phone he said refer to some other hospital. But due to a strong faith on that particular hospital, because years to years how the generation got delivered there and the doctor was known for normal delivery, she insisted, no, I want to get delivered here. Nurses has called the doctor, sir, we can do it because it is already, head is coming down. He said, okay, go ahead. Doctor was not there, only guidance on the phone. Delivery done by vacuum. Everything was fine, but patient went in PPH. Maybe some tear. On phone, whatever was best to be done, my doctor has done, but they could not able to stop the blood, so they called a surgeon and anesthetic, but by the time they came, patient was already vitally down. So referred to tertiary care center, their patient died. My doctor was booked under 304. Having a knowledge. Sisters were booked under 304. Having a knowledge that you are not qualified, but you proceeded for the delivery. Try to understand the era has changed. We are in an era where lots of changes we can see. And that's the reason it is amply important for us to really protect our own self. Consumer fora case. Criminal case and followed by the medical council cases. You know, medical councils where any case happens, people write to the ministry. You know, you have seen people CC to chief minister, CC to this, CC to that, and then every letter goes to council. So council by default need to inquire about the matter. And many of the time, being they are the doctors, we have seen if they don't get satisfied, they suspend you. Because the punishment there is suspension. And it is rampantly seen, even in criminal cases, where Supreme Court said that in any death case, expert opinion is mandatory before arresting a doctor. So normally expert opinion ke liye jata hai kiske paas, civil surgeon ke paas. But I'll tell you with my experience about two different signs. One is a law, second is a medicine. The law science is absolute science. Law means whatever act is mentioned is final. So 2 into 2, 4 means pregnant hai ya pregnant nahi hai. There is no may not be. But medical science is abstract science. Abstract means what? If for the same treatment, three doctors can differ in their treatment. One can think of forceful delivery. One can think of caesarean. Are you getting me? And all three are right. Like for malaria, one can think of artemether, other can plan for chloroquine, third may go for primaquine. But all the three have been mentioned in the book. So abstract science means there is a multiple approach and all approach is absolutely right approach. But what happens, you know? This is again an agony. If suppose I am a very severe practitioner. So my way of looking to the treatment is as per my era. And a young doctor who started his practice very recently are well versed with the technology. So his way of practice could be absolutely innovative. And if that case comes to me, if I don't see that case in accordance to my era, I always say it is wrong. Are you getting me? So because of this, the medical council punishment has increased, criminal cases have been in rise. In all scenario, only with my experience, way left with us is to know the defenses in such a cases. Because these things you can't stop. Consumer activist, you can't stop. Consumer Protection Act implementation, you cannot stop. Medical council is beyond your control. Police authority is nowhere in your control. Politician, no chance that you can do anything. So what you can do? You can defend yourself with a few important things which you need to follow during your medical practice, which is in your control. If you follow this, believe me, nothing is going to happen to you till the time you practice. And this I am going to share now, which I have learned in last 15 years with a different way of handling the cases, the best defenses which I was able to choose and present to my people. So, another hour probably I am going to discuss more about the defenses, and you are requested to please put in your mind and follow the same, execute the same. You will be really be safeguarded in criminal case also. You will be safeguarded in medical counsel cases also. You are going to be safeguarded in consumer fora courses and criminal cases also. The four important things which I am going to share with your people. First is the documentation. Second is the communication. The way your attitude should change towards the patient, the way you handle the patient should change. You know, give respect, take respect, you know. Observe yourself while practicing, how you get irritated, for what you get irritated and where you get irritated, and how your, you know, reflection goes to the patient. You know, for simple, you enter to the clinic, many of the time, if there is no cleanliness found, you are going to shout on that sweeper, and your hormone changes, and the first patient gone. Are you understanding? Yes, you need to control your temper when you are in a public domain. So, third is a professional indemnity. I am going to speak on professional indemnity because that is one of the greatest protection which law has given to you. Take advantage of that. Professional indemnity policy. I am going to talk about that. And a fourth important part is the medical legal education. Because I strongly believe in word of Gautam Buddha. He says, ignorance is cause of suffering. And if you replace ignorance with the knowledge, suffering ceases. So having a medical law knowledge is a bliss. I'll give you one example to make you understand why I'm saying so. Otherwise people are going to extort money from us. Like patients are not aware about medical knowledge. So whatever we say, they need to follow. Chaapi operation kara. With the fear of death, you will rush. Since you don't have a knowledge. But the same doctor family, you cannot do that. Because doctor has got a knowledge. He is not an emergency. Tomorrow also we can go and investigation, alternative anything. I'll share one case to make you understand why education is important. I got one case where wife got admitted with a poison intake to MD doctor in his hospital. Naturally, when wife has taken a poison, then naturally in-laws get scared, whatever happened in their house, but scared with the litigations of the police. So naturally, they take all the care, so they rushed to the hospital and this lady got admitted. Now, in-laws are going to pay the bill, it's dictum. So they have spoken to the doctor. They have spoken to the doctor, sir, please don't do MLC. MLC, you know, what is MLC? Medical legal company. Which we are mandated to do in any accident cases. If we don't do, it is a punishable offense. So, they request the doctor, please don't do MLC because we don't want to get entangled to police cases. Doctor has done stomach wash or primary treatment was done. Patient was stable. Even doctor inquired with after hour with that lady. लेकिन वो पूरे जिंदगी में इतना प्यार नहीं किया था husband ने एक घंटे में कर लिया. And then wife said, no, I have mistakenly taken. These are the stories. So doctor thought I'll do after some time, he was busy in some emergency. he forgot to do, inserted RMO, but RMO has forgot to do MLC. Around 6 o'clock, patient suddenly deteriorated and died. Now fear with the mind of doctor that I have not done MLC. Touch wood, he has not committed another crime by giving a death certificate. He immediately sent body for the postmortem. But that was remained in his mind that I have done a great mistake of not doing MLC. So he called someone. Ab Neem Hakim Khatra hai jaan. He called his colleague, who also was not having a knowledge of law. So bacha pucha dar isne dal diya uske dil mein. The serious crime, you don't know this thing, that thing, blah blah, and then given a number of some advocate. Now advocate has got their own limitations, try to understand. Like we medical doctor, we learn everything during UGPG, but 10 years of practical practice, do you remember what you studied in UGPG? I'll give an example. After 10 years, go to some gynecologist and show her ECG. Are you kidding me? Means during UGPG, she can easily read. I'm not giving example of gynecologist, go to any of the doctor other than medicine, who are not continuously in a process. So same happened with the advocate. Advocates are every day entangled into maramari cases like 323, 324, IPC, 376, murder cases and all. So MLC was rarest to rare for them. See, when they don't know, for that they need to refer a book. So when he called advocate never wanted to lose their opportunity of earning. And he also knows, doctor has created a fear in the mind of the patient and earned a good amount of money, and now it's my chance. So he said, doctor, immediately rush, because you can be arrested any moment. So go to Mahabaleshwar, send 1 lakh rupees to me, tomorrow I'll file anticipatory bail, pre-arrest bail, and I'll give you remedies. With the fear of arrest, doctor has sent 1 lakh rupees. Next day, when you know, you also, if you call 7 places, 6 places, you reach to me. So naturally, next day morning, you want to have a remedies and by some mean he reached to me. See, we are in this field. So we are expert in this field. You can't expect me to go and talk about divorce case, or you cannot say expect me to go for recovery case where I am not good, even being a lawyer. So I said, why you worry? Why I am sharing to you? Because you need to know the law. Then I said, not to worry, because section 171 of IPC says, if you fail to inform administrative authority, which is legally duty bound, then maximum punishment is 1 month imprisonment or 1,000 rupees fine. For your knowledge sake, the moment our word comes, we being needed to society, doctor, we being a white collar people, always get a benefit of power. So even in worst scenario, even if case would have got after 7 years, decided against us, then also it could be 1,000 rupees. But he tend to pay 1 lakh rupees of no reason. So that's the reason, the fourth important aspect of defending ourselves is knowing the basic. So I am there to help you all in all the four people, don't worry. Let me go reverse wise. For medical legal education, this is the platform where I come. Elabit always takes care of their students. So they, by default, may be needed to you or not, is a different story. But they have known that this is very important. And that's the reason I am always there. And not only here, but hereafter, anytime you need me, I am going to be with you. So that is one way of parting a knowledge. Second way, by default, we educate you. Because we always say, if you are interested in getting a knowledge, we have got a technology which is available free of cost to us. Like WhatsApp, email, which does not cost us. So we have got our team where we put whoever is interested, we put their name in that database. By default, knowledge goes to you. Smaller like how much days medical record should be kept, what is the law for OPD record keeping, what is the law for IPD report keeping, or what is the consent, everything. many of the things which I could not able to disclose here, or I cannot be able to get a time to speak to you, we educate. And the latest development. For the purpose of same, we always select the people who are interested. Selecting means your passion. So if you are interested in that, because everything I cannot disclose here, then you have to show your interest. But how you can show interest? You can text me on a WhatsApp, simple, or my number. Sir, I am interested in medical legal education. That's all. I am just practicing this, wanted to have. Or even text me an email. That's all. Your job is over. And then, whenever material comes to your WhatsApp, read it. Secondly, whenever any question comes during your practice, immediately ask the question. I answer because I learn from you. It's a both way, give and take. I am not perfect because many of the things new I learn. So you can ask me the question on WhatsApp, on email. I am going to answer it. So it is open always, it is not closed. Third, in any given emergency, during your medical practice, whatever practice you are doing, whichever path you are practicing, any issue comes to you, please call. It's absolutely free of cost. Discuss. Take a guidance and then act. Because that will help you to overcome all sort of a pain, because I just share my law knowledge, that's all. For the purpose of the same, I am giving my number, that's because the fourth I have taken first, you can take down my number. You just need to text me on that number, WhatsApp, that's all. Simple, your name, your degree, everything. I am interested. Why I want a qualification? Because I will focus on that particular, like suppose you are from cosmetic, I am going to focus on cosmetic case. If you are from meditation, I am going to focus on meditation. If you are dentistry, we are going to focus on dentistry, because it's related to you. So that category goes out. So you need to mention about your qualification. If you are from eyes doctor, I focus on eyes doctor. So that benefits you. That relates to you. So you can write down a number. It is 9323-44-6163. I repeat, 9323-44-6163. Advocate Arun Mishra, Advocate Dr. Arun Mishra. Alternate number I am giving you, in for emergency if you could not able to reach on this number, for your sake I am just giving one alternate number, that is 98191.
It's 4 times 9.
4 times 9. 98191-99991. WhatsApp is on both the number. One goes to my office. Other direct comes to me. 9323 direct number of mine. You can save as a medical legal consultant for any purposes. You can write my email ID also for any communication. Vakil Arun Mishra. V-A-K-I-L. V-A-K-I-L. Vakil Arun Mishra. A-R-U-N-M-S-H-R-A. @gmail.com. Alternatively, legal@drsrisk.com. That is my organization's name. Doctors Risk, DOCTORSRISK.com. You can go on website, you will learn lots of medical legal things. Doctors, DOCTORSRISK. DoctorsRisk.com.
Doctors
Risk. Risk. Doctors Risk. So legal@doctors.com. That's all right. So you can text me. Two email ID I have given. You will get a lot of information because we are there educating you in a medical legal training program also. If you are interested in that, you can ask me that. Medical legal training program is what? I'll just give it to you. Anything? So education is only in medical legal field, like a legal medical legal training program if you want to do, like alternatively with your career if you want to grow. So paramedical staff training is part of that. I'll explain you during my course why it is important, and medical legal consultant course.